Even 8 months after the breakout, we still have a lot of debate about when to reopen, about what places to reopen. We really think we need a strong empirical foundation for choosing reopening plans.
We created a computer model that basically uses mobility data to simulate the spread of infection of COVID-19.
We need to understand how people come in contact with each other. And our main insight in this research was to use anonymized, large-scale data coming from cell phones to understand mobility patterns and to understand contact patterns between the individuals in the population.
We model 10 of the largest metropolitan statistical areas in the US. So that includes places like Atlanta, Dallas, New York City, and overall that models 98 million people.
That tells us how people from different neighborhoods visit different types of places like parks, grocery stores, schools, churches, and so on. And also how long they stay there and what is the area of that place, so that we can compute the density of people in that location at any given time.
Using this data, we can simulate where and when people are getting infected. We find that just 10% of points of interest can account for over 80% of the infections for the city.
The places where the most infections occur are places where people are densely packed for long periods of time. So it is restaurants, coffee shops, and fitness centers.
We found that density caps are very successful in reducing disparities. By that I mean you cap the occupancy at some percentage of the maximum. And this is very important in reducing infections overall, which is great, but it's also, and this was an important finding, it's also a way to reduce disparities because it turns out that low-income groups, for example, are more likely to frequent places in which densities are high. For example, grocery stores in low-income neighborhoods tend to be higher in density, tend to be more crowded.
If you do something like cap the number of visits at 50% of maximum reoccupancy, we show that the economy will only lose, for example, 5 to 10% of POI visits, POI being points of interest, but at the same time, you're able to reduce the overall number of infections by over 50%.
Having the ability to understand how to reopen the economy, what effect would it have on the virus, and at the same time, how much business would be lost, gives a decision maker an important tool that can balance these two factors for the best possible outcome.